2020 marks 50 years since the Chicano Park landmark that we have here in San Diego started welcoming visitors from across the county and across the country. As ABC 10 News continues to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month, we spoke to a local author who is helping younger generations learn about the park's history through a new bilingual children's book. ABC 10 News reporter Vanessa Paz talked to the author about why learning about the park's past is important and how building the San Diego landmark almost didn't happen.
Where the 5 meets the Coronado Bridge, nestled under the loud noise of cars, sits a historic gem, a staple of Barrio Logan, Chicano Park.
Always growing, you know, new murals that are coming up, new activities.
Vibrant art, familiar sounds, and a sense of community is often what you find and feel.
I think people feel that energy, and they see those colors, and they see the images of faces that look familiar to them.
Uniting people of all backgrounds, from Hispanics, African Americans, to Latinos and Chicanos in particular.
We like to clarify that we are more than that. Yes, we do have Spanish heritage, but we also have Native American and Indigenous heritage.
Beatriz Zamora is an author, teacher, and member of Chicano Park's steering committee. Her first visit to the park was in the late 1970s.
Music and dance and speakers and beautiful mural art and paintings and lowriders and, you know, just so many different pieces of my culture all in one place. Being embraced in this wonderful celebration.
Becoming a part of its roots ever since.
It's a place where we come together sometimes to take action on various issues that are happening in the community.
But 50 years ago, Chicano Park almost didn't happen.
The story goes, Mario Solis is walking through the neighborhood and he sees these big construction equipment.
Alerting everyone he could, they made a human chain to stop the city from building what would have been a highway patrol substation. Thousands of Chicanos in the neighborhood were displaced back then after zoning changes and factories were built. The park was hope for their community.
They occupied the land for 12 days, and then they started to talk with city officials and others about them fulfilling their promise to build a park.
That story lives on through those who were there and now in a children's book by Zamora.
Some of these places and landmarks that they take for granted didn't just happen. It took people coming together who really cared about creating something for the children and something for the future.
Titled The Spirit of Chicano Park, in hopes that its spirit lives on.
Many of those elders have passed on now, and I do believe they leave a little bit of their energy and their love in that park, and that's what you feel.
The Spirit of Chicano Park is available online, and you can find it at many of the bookstores spread across San Diego. Now, for details on the book and where to learn more about the park's history, visit 10news.com. Vanessa Paz, ABC 10 News.